it's a long day. Living in Reseda, there's a freeway running through the yard. And I'm a bad boy, 'cause I don't even miss her. I'm a bad boy for breaking her heart. The vampires walking through the valley, move west down Ventura Boulevard. And all the bad boys are standing in the shadows, and the good girls are home with broken hearts.
Apples off in the valley, oh. mountains will shake, the castle wall, the ring rays are out in black. Ride on,
reservation,
ride on.
Shoot straight to the meatball.
No comfort yet, the fire at night, the lights are face so cold.
Dance in the dark at night, sing to the morning light.
Red and gold to bring the balance back.
Bring it back.
At last the sun is shining, the clouds are blue rolling by. From the dragon of darkness, some light finds his
eyes.
stand my ground, and I won't back down. No, I won't back down.
Best days riding for me were the best roads were day four. I think we had everything from being on Skye to Applecross Pass to mountainous regions to coastal regions through mountains, through foresty bits. It had absolutely everything in it. It really did. Everything. Another fantastic day weather-wise. Got everything ready to go and we were going to leave Skye, which was a little bit sad. Obviously James was very keen to go there. Was fantastic going there, seeing where his dad had stayed and everything else, and viewing Skye. So a little bit sad to go, but heading towards Rhodes, which we knew were going to be absolutely fantastic.
Tell me about the pass over to Applecross.
Absolutely wonderful, my favourite road, leading to a sort of magical, enchanting place. And until 1975, that was the only way you could get to Applecross, was over this pass, which is 2,000 feet high. The road's built on alpine type roads with 180 degree hairpins, etc. Just absolutely wonderful to ride, tremendous to do, and wonderful weather on this occasion. once down the other side, refueled, and then running north on the west side of the Applecross Peninsula with views across to Rasay and Skye in the background, the Cullen Mountains. It's just unbelievable. Again, single track road, wonderful roads to ride, wonderful bends passing through various farms, bits and pieces. And you come out to the top into a little place called Shieldag, which is superb, wonderful little place. And then you head out towards Torridon, and again it becomes absolutely wild, barren, lots of mountain climbing, all sorts there. And the whole scenery changes as well, so you have very sort of high rocky mountains, and then you'll hit patches of forestation, lochs, just completely changes noticeably as you sort of traverse that part of the world. Heading across that bit is wonderful.
James described that bit, actually, that really barren bit that it runs through there, as being much more like the Wild West than he ever expected North Scotland to look like.
Yeah, it was actually. In some ways, it is a bit like that. You could imagine that. We had a wonderful stop in Gairloch, a wonderful place called the Hillbillies Cafe and Bookshop. Very Lindsay-type place, I have to say. And Lindsay did love that. I think we all did, actually.
Bohemian.
Yeah, but it was wonderful. We stopped, we had a bite to eat. I remember I think I got an anti-fox hunting sticker for the bike. I got a book on the demise of the American Indian, which I read. It was just a wonderful, wonderful stop. And again, all the time we're just sort of motoring north. So my favourite part, let's think, as you ride up towards Loch Hugh, absolutely fantastic. Literally carving through the mountains, so you'll see the sea from time to time, then you'll swing inland again, back out some more sea. That's absolutely wonderful. And then the run down towards Little Loch Broom, absolutely wonderful as well. And then the road swings around and heads up to the road where, if you went left, you go to Ullapool, or you can go right, which is where we actually went. But that whole stretch is absolutely magical. Wonderful piece of road.